Hi, I'm Matthew Buzzi from PC Mag, and I'm here with the new Asus ROG Zephyrus G14 and G16, which have new designs and new components.
The Zephyrus G line has been a hit, particularly the hyper-portable G14, which we've reviewed quite favorably recently. These new looks are slick, both thinner and lighter than before. The aluminum chassis feels nice in hand, and the diagonal LED on the lid is an evolution of the dot matrix lid we've seen on these laptops before. You can customize the lighting strip with different colors and an array of patterns. Starting with the G14, it measures just 0.62 inches thick, and weighs 3.3 pounds, an appealing mobile form factor. That's not a tremendous difference in thinness and weight, but notable given that the device was already quite portable. Even with the trim down, the laptop's keycaps and touchpad are actually larger than before, and are comfortable for typing and working on the road. If I was using this touchpad to play simpler games away from my desk, I'd appreciate the extra room. The G14 will use the next generation of AMD's processors, the recently announced Ryzen 8000 series, up to the Ryzen 9 8945HS. There are no new NVIDIA GPUs at CES this year, so the RTX 40 series GPUs are still the latest and most powerful. In the G14's case, the GPU options include the RTX 4050, RTX 4060, and will top out at the RTX 4070. Limiting this machine to here, rather than offering an RTX 4080 or 4090, makes sense for the size. The system can push up to 90W TGP with dynamic boost, and a liquid metal thermal solution combines with a tri-fan design to keep this compact body running cool. It's not just the design and components that are built to impress. The display is a head-turner too. The G14 will use the ROG Nebula display, which runs up to a 3K OLED panel with a 120Hz refresh rate and NVIDIA G-Sync support. As you'd expect, it looks pretty great. Asus also has improved the laptop sound, with 6 louder speakers and a larger woofer. It uses a 180W power connector for charging rather than USB-C charging, but still includes USB-C, mini SD card, USB-A, and HDMI connections. As for the G16, much of the same core ideas apply, but with some key differences. They share the redesigned style, and this machine is narrowly thinner and nearly half a pound lighter than its predecessor. The Nebula display is similar, though it tops out at a 2.5K OLED panel and adds a vapor chamber to the cooling solution. Where the new G14 and G16 differ the most is the components. This machine will use Intel's Core Ultra Meteor Lake processors up to the Core Ultra 9 185H. That's somewhat of a surprise, even though this is a thinner machine, you'd maybe expect this type of laptop to go for Intel's recently announced 14th gen Raptor Lake refresh chips. But since the Core Ultra line also scales up to a 9 tier and has its own high-performance H series, we're excited to see its gaming chops. Core Ultra has the benefit, of course, of the built-in NPU for AI-related tasks, giving this laptop a leg up on a wider range of automated workloads. The main G16 models will stick to the RTX 4050, 4060, and 4070, keeping to the core idea that these are capable but still portable performers. However, and somewhat going against that idea, Asus noted there will be additional versions of the G16 available with RTX 4080s and 4090s. Both laptops offer a choice of one-zone RGB backlighting or all-white lighting for the keyboard, as well as a 1080p IR webcam.
That's all on these systems. For more on all of CES 2024 and from Asus, check out PCMag.com.